Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode from networkfromhome.com. We have a short video for you today, and we're going to be talking about how to identify the Ethernet cables in your network. I have three examples to show you. Each Ethernet cable might be slightly different depending upon where you get it from and the manufacturer, but the bottom line is here, we want to have the ability to identify what Ethernet cables we have and which ones that we're using. Obviously, the benefit there in being able to identify the Ethernet cables in your network, you'll be able to understand if they are sufficient for your internet plan, for your devices, and the information moving along your network. The reason for that being each category of Ethernet cable supports a different maximum speed or a maximum transmission speed. So basically what we want to do here is we want to be able to look at our cables, identify what we have, and then we can make some decisions about if we have to replace them, if the ones that we have are sufficient, and so on. So let's go ahead. Let's take a look at a few examples here. It's pretty easy to identify the cables that you have. You just have to know what you're looking for. So essentially, and again, this depends upon the manufacturer or where you get your cables from, but there's usually some labeling on the side of every Ethernet cable. So let's go ahead and take a look at an example of that now. Here's example number one. And what we're going to be looking for is the category identifier of these Ethernet cables. And then you can look up pretty easily what speeds that Ethernet cable supports based upon the category that that cable fits into. And I have written an associated blog post with this, which has a table that breaks all this down if you want to check that out. Okay, so here in the first example, it says data cable Cat5e UTP 24AWG with some other descriptors on it. What we're focused on right here is the Cat5e portion that identifies that this cable is a Cat5e cable, meaning that it can support speeds up to 1 gigabit per second. This is a great first example here. Most Ethernet cables that you see will have similar labels on them. You'll see in the third example, that's not always the case, but this is a good start here. You'll also, for the cables that you'll see in most common networks, you'll see Cat5e, you'll see Cat6, or even Cat6a. Those are all sufficient cables for most internet plans and networks today. But let's take a look at another example here. All right, for this next one here, you see it's very similar. Cat6 UTP patch cable ISO/IEC, blah, blah, blah. But here, similar to the other one, it identifies pretty clearly Cat6. You know this is a category 6 cable. And UTP stands for unshielded twisted pair. That's less important here because our main focus is on the category of cable and identifying the transmission speeds it supports. All right, let's take a look at the third example. It's a little bit different than these other two. All right, for this one, you see there's a lot less information on the side of the cable. The label just says Cat6 network cable. This was an Ethernet cable I got online. Again, it's pretty easy to identify that it's a category 6 cable. There's just not a lot of other information on the label itself. So it makes it easy for you to identify the type of cable it is. It's a little unconventional in terms of the format of the labeling, but regardless, this is another format that you may see depending upon where you get your cables from. Okay, so that pretty much covers it. We have three examples that I showed you for Ethernet cables. But the bottom line is the same, regardless of where you get your cables from, what they look like, what type of cable they are, just look closely at the side of the cable itself And somewhere it'll say cat, whether it's 5E, cat 6, cat 6A. Those are the ones you'll generally see. They're all sufficient for most networks, but the bottom line is you should be able to identify them to make sure. If you have a Cat 5 cable in your environment, you'll probably want to upgrade it. That's just one example, but the bottom line is, in order to identify your cables and know if it's correct or it's the right cable for your network, you need to be able to identify it. And now you should have the ability to do that. Okay, so that's all we have. Thanks for tuning in to networkfromhome.com. As I mentioned, I wrote a blog post about this as well with a little bit more detail, and it also breaks down the maximum data transfer speeds of each category of cable. So once you've identified your cables, you can see the speeds that it supports. I'll link to that down below if you're curious. As always, thanks for tuning in to networkfromhome.com. We'll see you in the next episode.